This interview is one of a series. We look at common analysis problems and how to solve them. Today we are talking to Glenn Woods, an ICP-MS specialist at Agilent. Hello, Glenn.
Hello, Isabel. Hello, everyone.
Glenn, the pandemic forced many labs to implement social distancing and remote working. Instruments typically require someone to monitor the progress of sample analysis. What have they done to cope with this situation?
Well, Isabel, labs can often be crowded places. They are expensive to build, so organizations try to squeeze in as much as possible. This results in a high density of people. When social distancing became the norm, the number of people in a lab had to be reduced. This often meant that someone had to monitor multiple instruments, including those they didn't have any experience on.
So what did they do?
They got the senior analysts to set up and validate the analytical method, and then got them out of the lab. The junior analysts were left to load up samples and monitor analyses.
But how did they cope without experience in a sophisticated technique like ICP-MS?
If they had an Agilent ICP-MS, they could use a browser-based interface called ICP-Go. This is a hugely simplified interface that an analyst can learn to use in less than a day. True. ICP-Go gives access only to the settings required to run the sample batch. This prevents click-happy junior here from accidentally changing a critical setting.
So where were the senior analysts and what role did they play in this approach?
The senior analysts were at home or in another part of the building. They could do things like make adjustments to settings remotely, check a result, or monitor internal standards.
Do you see this approach continuing after the pandemic?
Yes, it proved to be a great way to introduce more labor flexibility into the lab. Staff absences can be better managed, and senior analysts can be freed from routine sample analysis too, so they can add more value to operations.
Thank you, Glenn, for another interesting solution to a common lab problem.
You're more than welcome, Isabel. Thank you.